Hello dear students, first of all I'd like to welcome you all in the commerce stream, and this is Rashminder Sahi and I'm going to take your business studies. As you all know, the subjects we are going to do in commerce are totally new for all of you, right? So before starting with the chapters which are part of your curriculum, you should know what is business studies, basically what is the objective of business studies, right? So I'll give you a small brief of the subject of business studies. So business is basically a dynamic process which brings together technology, natural resources and human initiative in a constantly changing global environment, right? To understand this framework in which a business operates, a study of detail knowledge is required regarding the organizations, managements which are being carried in the business houses, and its interaction with the environment is very much required, right? So globalization basically have changed the thinking regarding the business being carried on in the traditional times as well as now the changes which have occurred in the modern times. So globalization is one of the factor. Another factor is the information technology, which is now becoming a very integral part of the business operations, right? Video conferencing, we say the meetings are being done on the video conferencing and so on. Finally, basically we can say this course of business studies, it helps to prepare students to analyze, manage, evaluate and respond to the changes which are being occurring in our country as well as in other countries, because we are very much connected with each other, right? So it also provides students a way of looking at and interacting with the business environment, the environment which is basically prevailing in the surroundings of a business house. So it also recognizes the fact that business influences and is basically influenced by many social environments, which may be social, political, economic or legal, right? So this subject also allows students to appreciate that business is an integral component of society, and it develops an understanding of many social and ethical issues. So finally, to acquire basic knowledge of the business world, a course in business studies would be very much useful to the students. It will also help the students to act more effectively and responsibly as consumers, employers, employees and citizens. So I hope the of studying business studies is very much clear to all of you. It is not only a subject, it basically provides us the framework of what is occurring around us, right? It's basically the foundation for you people to understand what is actually business studies, right? I hope the importance of the subject is very much clear to all of you. So now, starting with the units of your syllabus, there are basically two parts, in which in the first part there will be 6 chapters and in the second part there will be 4 chapters, right? So now I'll be taking part A, and the chapter I'm taking is basically the nature and purpose of business. So let us start with the chapter. Number one thing we'll be doing is basically, what is business? So business is basically an economic activity which includes production, sales of goods and services with the only motive, only aim of earning profit and satisfying the human wants or needs. So in other words, we can say that it is an economic activity, which means basically the activities which we carry on to earn the profits. So business is an economic activity which aims at earning profit by producing and selling of goods and services. So there are two kinds of business activities, that is economic and non-economic. So as I told you earlier, economic activities are those activities which are basically done for earning profit, right? For example, you are carrying on any business and you are earning profit on that particular business. That is basically known as economic activity, right? Another is, second type is non-economic activity. Non-economic activity is an activity in which The purpose is not to earn the profit but mental satisfaction of a person, right? For example, any person doing some seva in gurdwaras or mandirs, right? Or any person making some donations or charities, this is basically known as non-economic activities. I hope the types of business activities are very much clear to all of you. Moving on to the next topic, that are basically the types of economic activities. I hope the meaning of economic activity is clear to all of you, that is, which is being carried on to earn the profits. So now there are basically three kinds of economic activities, that is business, profession and employment. As I told you, business is basically a purpose or an occupation in which people engage in the activities like purchasing, production and sale of goods and services with the only motive to earn the profit. This is the meaning I have already explained to you people. This is the first kind of economic activity, right? Moving on to the second type or the kind of economic activity, that is the profession. So profession, basically it refers to the paid occupation, especially one that involves prolonged training and a formal qualification. For example, we can say the doctors, the chartered accountants, lawyers, they all are basically the professionals. So this is basically in which a person is involved in the studies for a long period of time, in a formal qualification, you can say, right? And later on, when he receives the degree for that, he can carry on that particular profession, right? I hope the meaning of profession is also clear to all of you. Now, moving on to the third type of economic activity, it is basically known as the employment. So, employment, it refers to the condition of having a paid work, right? For example, any person working in an office, and that particular person is basically known as employee, and his boss will be known as the employer. And for granting his services to the employer, employee will get salary in return, right? I hope the three types of economic activities, that is business, profession and employment, is very much clear to all of you. So now the next topic we'll going to do is basically the difference between business, profession and employment, right? So starting with the first point, number one is the basis. Basically, first is nature of work. In business, the nature of work is basically the provision of goods and services to the public. And in profession, it is rendering of the personalized expert services to the people. And in employment, it is performing the work as per the service contract or the rules of the service which is being provided by the employer to the employee. Right? I hope the first point, that is nature of work, is clear to all of you. Moving on to the next point, it is qualification. Right? As we know that in business, we do not for carrying on business, we do not require any kind of qualification. No minimum qualification, basically, we can say that is necessary, right? No doubt people are now doing MBAs and then start their business or they carry or take over the business of their parents. So, but in this, no minimum qualification is required under business, right? Moving on to the profession, as I told you, proper training is there under profession. So qualifications are required, expertise training is required, and that is basically required by any kind of professional body. For example, for becoming a lawyer, a person needs a degree from the Bar Council of India, right? So next, moving on to the employment. In this, the qualification and training is prescribed by the employer. For example, any person is doing a job as a finance manager, so his qualification will be according to that, right? Next, moving on to the next point, it is reward or return. So in business, the reward is profit. In profession, the reward is the professional fees. And in employment, the reward is salary or the wages, right? Moving on to the next point, it is capital investment. In this point, as we know that for starting any kind of business, we need a very high amount of capital. So in this, the capital investment is very much high. In profession, limited capital is there. For example, any person have done the MBBS, now he wants to start his hospital, so he'll require the funds accordingly, right? And next one, last one is employment. No capital investment is required for being an employee in any kind of organization, right? Next, moving on to the point is risk. So business, you know, the high risk is there, right? Because there are uncertainties, irregularities are there. So risk is very much involved in the business. In profession, a person gets regular fees. So some kind of risk is there. Not high risk, some risk is there. And employment, from employee's point of view, there is no risk because he'll be getting the pay regularly, because that is basically a fixed and regular. That is why there is no or little risk is there, right? So next is transfer of interest. So in business, the transfer is possible. For example, a person taking over business of his dad, that is, so transfer is easy and possible, right? But in profession, there is no possibility of transfer. Any person having an MBBS degree, he cannot pass on his MBBS degree to anybody, right? So there is no percentage of transfer of the interest. And in employment also, there is no possibility that you can transfer your work to any other person. So there is also no possibility of transfer of the interest, right? So next is code of conduct. In code of conduct, basically code of conduct is what? Rules and regulations, right? So in business, for starting business, there is no prescribed code of conduct, right? But in profession, you know, there is a prescribed code of conduct, which is basically given by the bodies, professional bodies who are running that particular degrees. And in employment, the code of conduct is basically the code of conduct which is being laid down by the employer for his employee, right? Which the employee has to follow. So moving on to the last point, that is examples. In business, it can be shop or factory. In profession, it can be legal, medical or chartered accountancy, as I told you earlier. And in employment, it can be jobs in the banks, insurance companies, government departments, etc. Right. So here we come to an end on with the difference between these three economic activities. I think these three economic activities are very much clear to all of you.